So the breeding gestation room is where we breed pigs. We do detection of estrus. We use artificial insemination for breeding. And then they remain in that room until shortly before farrowing, which is having babies, when they'll move to the farrowing room. So in the breeding gestation room, we have a combination of individual gestation stalls, as well as pens for group housing. In the United States, most sows are in gestation stalls for at least a portion, if not the majority of gestation. These stalls were an innovation, really, in the 1960s, when farmers saw that sows were fighting, which is part of pig behavior. And so pregnant pigs or pigs that were being mated were fighting, and smaller pigs are getting beat up, and smaller, skinnier sows were getting less feed and getting skinnier, and fatter sows were getting fatter. And so really in the 1960s is when the gestation stalls were introduced as an effort to improve the well-being of pregnant sows. And some people that are really not familiar with literature or with pig production in particular, I've got very opposed to gestation stalls, because in that facility, the stall is about 2 feet wide and 7 feet long. So the idea is to give her her own space, protect her from fighting, allow her individual access to her full daily ration of feed without having competition. But we really don't want them to turn around just from a sanitation standpoint. And of course, that also would lead to much bigger facilities. So, some people don't like the idea that the sow can't turn around. So in the United States today, we do have a lot of farms that are both new farms, as well as older farms, established farms that are doing conversions to put sows into group housing for either a larger part or all of gestation. And so in this facility, we've got sows, the opportunity to house sows both ways, and we talk about why people might want to do one versus the other. So if you look in the room, you'll see the feed boxes. So each stall has its own individual feed box, and then the pens would have multiple feed boxes because there would be multiple animals. Those feed boxes are adjustable, so we control how much feed is delivered with each pull of the lever, as it were. So each box has a ball that plugs the bottom of the box, and there's an auger at the top. The auger draws feed from the outside feed bin and puts in as much feed as we have allocated based on the auger. That feed is changed depending on the size, the body condition, and the stage of pregnancy that the pig is in. And then either once or twice per day, usually once per day, somebody pulls the lever, it raises the ball in all the boxes at the same time, and it allows one person to feed all the sows at the same time. Usually at about 110 days of gestation, maybe 111, after being mated, they will move to the farrowing room.